बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम टू एवरीवन इन कैंप बूस्टर विद्या शहजादी। आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू विद द न्यू टॉपिक एंड द न्यू चैप्टर एंड आल्सो वेलकम वार्मली वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन माय चैनल। ओके, वी आर गेट टुडे स्टार्टिंग द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ आवर नाइन्थ क्लास, दैट इज द पीरियोडिक टेबल एंड द पीरियोडिसिटी ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज। Here, the periodicity and the periodic table, that is the finalized periodic table that was assigned, that was planned after the different models that were presented by the different scientists after all years. This was the final look of the periodic table that was assigned or that was planned for the classification of the elements into the different elements. Periodic table or the classification of the elements. The classification of the elements was depend upon the different theories and the different periodic tables are the different properties are the different models that were presented by the different scientists and were experienced by the time, and these were the basically the initially experiment that was performed for the trying the classification of the elements. The first of all was the De Bruyne's triad and the Newland's octaves, Mendeleev's periodic table and the periodic law. These were the four law that was basically the base of the classification of the elements and the final base of the classification of the periodic table. First, let's get started towards the De Bruyne's triad that was presented by a German chemist, De Bruyne, that observed the relationship between the atomic masses of the several atoms of the three elements that was called the triads. He called the relationship of the atomic masses of the several groups of the three elements that was the triads. This was the basic concept of the De Bruyne's triads. That's why its name is De Bruyne's triad. This was represented by the De Bruyne's scientist, and the triad was the relationship of the three elements that is called the triads. The central atom or the middle atom that held the atomic masses or the average atomic mass of the other two elements. In the triad, there was a concept behind this, that if we are taking the two elements, that is the first and the third, then we are able to take the average atomic masses of the second element, that was the correct according to De Bruyne's triad for the different elements. And this was just classified for the 20 elements of the periodic table, that was the first 20 elements of the periodic tables. And its example is the, if we want to take the example of the lithium, sodium and the potassium. The lithium has the atomic number of the atomic mass of the 6.9 and the potassium has the 39. So when we take the average of these two atomic elements, when we want to get, we will get the atomic number, the atomic mass of the sodium element, that is the 23. When we add up the 6.9 plus 39, we will get and divided this towards the two, and we will get the 23 atomic mass, that is the atomic mass of the sodium element, that was the according to the De Bruyne's triad. And look at towards the second example, that is the calcium, strontium and the barium. This was the example of the triads De Bruyne's, and the calcium has the atomic mass of the 40 and the strontium has the 88, that is the average atomic mass of these two, the calcium plus barium. 137 is add up towards the 40, and when we divided it towards the 2, we will get the 88, that is the atomic mass of the strontium according to the De Bruyne's triad. But this classification was of some demerits due to their limitations, because only the few elements were arranged in this way and the others were not arranged in this way, and the not discovered element was not placed in their periodic table of the De Bruyne's triad. So that's why. Here is the De Bruyne's triad. When we take the sodium element, that here is represented by the triangles at the top of the triangle. Here is the that element that we want to take the average atomic mass of those two elements that are lying behind the triads or our triangle. When we take the sodium, lithium and the potassium, we will obtain the sodium mass, atomic mass of the sodium, and when we take the calcium, strontium and the barium, we will get the atomic mass of the strontium, and when we take the chlorine, barium, bromine and the iodine, we will get the bromine atomic mass according to the triads, and so on. New lands octaves. That was the second experimental and the second theory that was a successful determination of the corrective masses, atomic masses, by the Cannizzaro reactions. That was the Cannizzaro in the 1860s, and he attempts were again initiated to organize the elements in the different ways. Basically, in the classification of the elements want to arrange in the classify system, that was the in a periodic table. In 1864, the British chemist Newland put forward his observation in the form of the law of the octaves. He gave a law that was the law of the octaves. According to his law, he noted a repetition in the chemical properties of the every eighth element if they were arranged in their increasing atomic masses. If we arrange the elements in their increasing atomic masses, on the basis of increasing atomic masses, the elements were arranged like that. The first and the eighth element have the same chemical properties as well as the same physical properties due to their repetitions of their properties in a periodic manner that was given by the Newland octaves, and there was no space for the undiscovered element as well as the noble gases were not discovered at that time. So Newland was not able to place the noble gases as well as the undiscovered elements in the periodic table. So that's why these were the demerits of the Newland octaves, and he was failed. According to the Newland octaves, he related this theory towards the music system. He gave them the musical tune that was the Sa Re Ga Ma Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. The eighth element, every eighth element, if we want to take the lithium, and the lithium has the same chemical properties according to the sodium. That was the Sa Re Ga Ma Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. According to the musical rhythms that was assigned by the names for the chemical properties of the elements in the classification of the elements. But this classification has the different demerits because he placed the cobalt and the nickel in the same periodic table and the same manners, and the fluorine, chlorine and the bromine was placed, that were the halogens, and he placed them in the metals. These were the demerits, and he arranged only the 56 elements according to his musical tune arrangement. So that's why he was failed. Then the other scientist start Russian scientist who was the Mendeleev. He arranged the noun elements, only the 63 elements, in the increasing order of the atomic masses in the horizontal rows, that was called the periods, and the element with the similar properties were placed in the same vertical columns. He divided the elements into the columns and the rows according to their chemical and the physical properties. This arrangement of the element was called the periodic table. He put forward the results of his work in the form of the periodic law that was given at the this law state that the properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic masses. He was also arranging the element on the basis of the atomic masses. He was considering that the atomic masses are the most important factor for the classification of the elements. All the Mendeleev have the so many properties or the so many functional importance in their discoveries, but there was a few demerits behind the periodic table of the Mendeleev's periodic table. This was this was the first attempt to arrange the elements, but he has the further demerits that was that the position of the isotopes and the wrong order of the atomic masses of the some elements suggested in the atomic masses of the element cannot survive on the basis of the arrangement of the elements. This was the demerits about the Mendeleev's periodic table. And the periodic law, that was the lost law that was represented by the H. Moseley in 1913 for the discovery of the atomic masses. He was one of the scientists and the most important scientist who discovered the atomic mass, who arranged to classify the elements on the basis of the atomic numbers, not on the basis of the atomic masses. He classified the elements into the in the periodic table. He observed the atomic number instead of the atomic mass should determine the position of the elements in the periodic table, and according to the periodic law was amended as the further changes that was produced in the periodic table, that was that the properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic masses, not their atomic numbers. Sorry, the properties of the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic numbers, that not on the basis of the atomic masses. The atomic number is an element is equal to the numbers of the electrons in a neutral atom. The atomic number is equal towards the numbers of the electron in an element, but the atomic mass is equal towards the numbers of the proton plus number of the neutrons in any element. So the atomic number provided on the basis of the electronic configuration is was the well. He was the one scientist who classified the periodic table or the classified the elements on the basis of this, that the properties of the elements are the periodic function. They repeated their properties as the physical or the chemical properties on the basis of the atomic numbers, not on the basis of the atomic masses. So this is the last topic of our lecture, that is the test or the activity we always do for the testing or for preparing ourselves for the classification of the elements. How the classification? So here are the few questions for to test yourself. First question is that what was the contribute of the De Bruyne towards the classification of the element? He was the first scientist who gave us the De Bruyne triad for the classification of the element on the basis of the atomic mass. He was the one scientist who says that if we want to take the atomic mass of the central atom, we can do this by taking the average of the first and the third element of the periodic table. How the Newland arranged the element? He arranged the element on the basis of their chemical properties on the first priority of the atomic masses, and that was the demerit about the Newland arrangement of the element. Who introduced the name of the periodic table? The periodic table name was given by the Newlands. That was the periodic table. The Mendeleev was the one who gave the name of the periodic table towards the arrangement of the elements in towards the classification of the elements. Why the improvement in Mendeleev's periodic table was made? Because the Mendeleev's periodic table was says that the periodic properties of the element was on the basis of the atomic masses. That was not correct. According to the H. Moseley, in 1913, he played a major role in the classification of the elements, and according to him, the periodic properties of the element was on the basis of the atomic numbers, not on the basis of the atomic mass. Who state the Mendeleev's periodic law? That was the periodic law that according to the periodic properties of the element was arranged in the number of the atomic masses. So this was that. And why and how elements are arranged in a periodic table? The elements are arranged in a periodic table on the basis of the increasing order of their atomic numbers, and these are the periodic properties of the elements. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Keep doing this, and also like, share and subscribe my videos to others, and take care of yourself.